As you can tell, we have learned and grown academically, but there are lessons that apply to life that we have learned as well. For example, in our first 9 years, we learned that school isn't that scary, and making friends wasn't that difficult. We learned what pickled asparagus tastes like, thanks to Miss Avery. We learned that dragon dollars are not of all their value. We learned that the students of Pierce, Summersville, and Greensburg Elementary can coexist in one school building. We learned that Edgar Allan Poe was a creepy guy. And we learned that Blake
We learned how cool it was to dress like a greaser. We learned what Gavin looked like dressed as a girl. And we learned that there is a pool on the roof.
Sophomore year, we learned that Chris Blaze knows everything. We learned how to drive. We learned that when Kenneth is elected to student council, he will be removed. Immediately. We learned what happens when we set a tire fire behind the school.
Junior year, we learned that Logan never ran it through school, and never will. We danced at the masquerade ball. We learned that the high school is infested with mice and the occasional rat. We learned that Mr. Rice is a good guy. Junior year was also the year that the world was introduced to Paper Sean. We binge-watched Stranger Things, Grey's Anatomy, and The Office on Netflix. And we learned that we hate cash time. Well, that's until our ACT scores went up.
Senior year is the year that no one remembers who their CCR teacher is. In August, we learn where we're going to college, and then we change our minds. We learn that it is really cool to finally paint a parking spot until they blacktop right over it. We learn that bathroom monitors are a necessity when you have amateur goblins running around your school. And we finally found that pool on the roof. We learned what it was like to lose a friend.
And then we learned our
difference. We learned to rely on each other.
We learned how to grow stronger.
We learned that as a class, we can make it through anything.
Through thick and thin, the class of 2018 has stuck together. And now that our 13 years are coming to an end, we prepare to go our separate ways. In just a few days, we will walk across this stage, no longer as students, but as graduates, a monumental task for each and every one of us. Our time here at Green County High School has taught us lessons that are too numerous to count. However, one will always stand above the rest. We are, and we will always be, friends.
Family.
The Green County High School Class of 2018.
Here we are. encouraging me. I have to think you all feel something like this as well. That first day of school, when they told us we would be the class of 2018, I couldn't fathom this day would ever come. But here we are, and we will all be facing a new first day. The first day after graduation, and the first day of the rest of our lives. The German philosopher Eckhart said, "And suddenly, you just know it's time to start something new and trust the magic of new beginnings." With the quick approach of graduation, we are all faced with a new, magical beginning. I have learned that endings make beginnings, and it's how we choose to perceive the moment that makes the difference between happiness and sadness. What does the future hold for us? Will it be the workforce? The military? Marriage and a family of our own? College? What is next for this class of 2018? We have the opportunity to create our own future, and I pray it is filled with hope. I hope we leave here with dreams to be fulfilled, and I hope we use the knowledge we obtained to fulfill those dreams. I hope we can enrich not just our own lives, but the lives of others. So, to my graduating class, I congratulate you. I am beyond proud of each and every one of you. Whichever path you choose, I pray this blessing on you from numbers 6, 24 through 26. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine on you and be gracious to you. The Lord turn his face toward you and give you peace.
On behalf of the graduating class of 2018, I pass this torch to you with much honor. We are proud to pass to you our memories, our victories, and our belief in the goodness and hope of the future. Take these gifts we have left you with our blessing and friendship, and wear them well.
On behalf of the class of 2019, I accept this torch with humility. Our class will strive to ensure memories, victories, and beliefs are kept and cherished so that we too feel honored when our time comes to pass the torch.
Nearly $1.2 million to 18 very deserving seniors.
awards.
Our merit scholarships are then depending on a student's GPA and ACT, and we award those scholarships at a variety of levels named after former presidents. So we award the Merit Grant, Horton, AP White, L.R. McDonald, and the B.B. Henry Presidential Scholarship. You will also hear me refer to several endowed scholarships, which I must mention because those are scholarships that are generously given by friends of Lindsey Wilson to honor an individual or family and specific and carry specific requirements, often including being a resident of Greene County. Specifically, the Carrie and Bonnie Gibbons Endowed Scholarship, Milton Jones Endowed Scholarship, and the Bill and Jane Squire Scholarship all allow African people to earn an education close to home affordably. The Legacy Scholarship is also reserved for students whose parents or grandparents have graduated from Lindsey Wilson, and our Artistic and Athletic Scholarships are awarded based upon the achievements of students who wish to advance their educational experience while attending school. Receiving Horton Academic, Bill and Jane Squires, and an Instrumental Scholarship is Parker Bagby. Receiving Horton Academic and Bill and Jane Squires Scholarship, Rachel Unfair.
Scholarship,
receiving L.R. McDonald Academic Scholarship and Green Partnership, Catherine Peterson. Receiving Horton Academic Scholarship, Bill and James Squires, and Green Partnership Scholarship, Ms. Jada Pierce. Receiving Horton Academic Scholarship, Bill and James Squires, and a Bowling Scholarship, Mr. Alexander Price. Receiving L.R. McDonald Academic Scholarship and Bill and James Squires Scholarships, Erica Smith. Receiving L.R. McDonald Academic Scholarship, Bill and James Squires, and a Legacy Scholarship, Mitchell Payton Squires. Receiving a Legacy Scholarship and Instrumental Scholarship, Mr. Jalen Willis. And receiving Horton Academic Scholarship, Bill and James Squires, Givens Endowed Scholarship, and a Basketball Scholarship, Mr. Isaac Young. After each of my 18 years of serving in Greene County High School, I think it's impossible to be touched more by a group of young people. I've come to realize that you guys are no exception. I am so impressed by the quality of young men and women, and know that the future of our community is as strong as it's ever been. Class of 2018, congratulations, and thank you for making my year a great one. Parents, teachers, and administration, job well done. I applaud each of you and your efforts in creating a strong future for our community, and one in which Ben and I are so proud to raise our family. Thank you. On behalf of the University of Kentucky, I would like to present Taylor Judd with a Provost Scholarship and a Kentucky Future Scholarship. My name is Laura Day, and I'm the Senior Enrollment Counselor at Hamilton University. With me tonight is Andrea Underwood, our Dual Credit Enrollment Counselor. Both of us have had the honor and pleasure of working with your students this year. On behalf of Dr. Michael Carter and Hamilton University, we would like to congratulate the Class of 2018 for their outstanding achievements and academic success. You are truly one of the most exciting and gifted classes that we have had the opportunity to work with this year. We are so excited that 14 outstanding graduates from Greene County High School have chosen to attend Hamilton University this fall. Tonight, it is my honor to present over $1 million in renewable scholarships to the following students. Receiving an academic scholarship of $15,500, Baptist Leadership Award, Competitive Bonus Award, and Key Snatching Scholarship, Mason Atwood.
receiving an academic scholarship of $15,500, Baptist Leadership Award, Kentucky Baptist Scholarship, and Keys Matching Scholarship, Brantley Caldwell. Receiving an academic scholarship of $12,500 and Keys Matching Scholarship, Amber Callahan. Receiving the Heartland Award of $10,000, Rachel Froggett. Receiving the Heartland Award of $10,000, Kenzie Payton. Receiving the academic scholarship of $15,500 and a softball athletic performance grant, Ivy Hedgehead. Receiving an academic scholarship of $15,500 and a softball athletic performance grant, Hannah Jett. Receiving an academic scholarship of $13,500, Keys Matching Scholarship, and athletic performance grant, Christian Carnes. Receiving an academic scholarship of $14,500 and Keys Matching Scholarship, Cody Larimar. Receiving a Heartland Award of $10,000, Lyric Milby. Receiving the Heartland Award of $10,000, excuse me, Christina Milby. Receiving the Heartland Award of $10,000, Christina Perkins. Receiving the academic scholarship of $15,500, the Baptist Leadership Award, the Kentucky Baptist Scholarship, and Keys Matching Scholarship, Megan Piles. Receiving the academic scholarship of $12,500 and Keys Matching Scholarship, Kiana Shu. And receiving the academic scholarship at $12,500 and Keys Matching Scholarship, Bianca Trail. Again, congratulations to the class of 2018. May your futures be richly blessed and full of continued success. Good evening, everybody. My name is Allison Manley. I'm a 2015 graduate of Western Kentucky University, and I'm
currently serve as the coordinator of outreach for the Office of Admissions. I am thrilled and honored to be here tonight to recognize and officially welcome students to the Hilltopper family. On behalf of President Cavoni, our faculty, staff, and alumna, WKU would like to congratulate the Green County High School senior class of 2018 and wish them the best in their future endeavors. WKU prides itself on recognizing and rewarding these students for their outstanding efforts and achievements throughout high school. WKU offers academic merit awards to students who have displayed excellence in the classroom and show promise to the future. The following students have accepted renewable academic awards to WKU. Sean Alamo,
congratulations, class of 18. I'm Todd Smirchinski, two-time University of Louisville graduate. First, I'd like to thank and shout out to my nephew, Matthew Gibbons, and my two girls, Allie and Shelby. We love you guys and we're very proud of you. Great things are really in your future. What makes University of Louisville so special? First and foremost, my wife and I graduated in graduate school, so I got my master's degree. And next, reminds me of a special friend I lost last year, a fanatic Carter. I'm sure you're watching and smiling. Since the inauguration in 1798, the University of Louisville has evolved into a premier nationally recognized metropolitan research institution. When you walk around campus, you are going to interact with people who you were there to learn, make a difference, and take U of L to the next level. Our students represent some of the most academically talented students in the region. There's no better time than to be a Louisville partner. Over the past year, the University of Louisville has had great pleasure of working with many talented future students from Green County High School. take a moment to recognize a student who has received an academic merit scholarship and plans to become part of the Hardin family this fall. I am pleased to present the trustee scholarship to William Simpson. Good luck to all of you.
Good evening and congratulations. Congratulations to the parents as well. My name is Mike Torrey, and I'm here with Mitzi and Philip Hay, and we're here to present the Philip Marshall Hay Scholarship, Memorial Scholarship. Before I begin, let me just tell you a little bit about Philip. Philip was a 99 graduate of Greene County, a member of the 98 Cross Country State Championship team. Back there in that picture. And to me, he was a member of our class at the College of Pharmacy at the University of Kentucky. This event is so amazing to me. I also went to the high school in Kentucky, but we didn't have anything like this. This community should applaud itself for the support and effort that it must take to put on this event year in and year out. It's remarkable, I'm sure it's greatly appreciated. And for Philip and Mitzi, on a personal note, I just want to let you know whether you like it or not, you adopted 96 pharmacists. And a personal note for me, I love you all and cherish your friendship. With that said, we have a pair of scholarships to award this year, each one of them $1,000, and the recipients are Sky Moss. And Sarah Jenner. Thank you all.
On behalf of the Burley Tobacco Growers Association, I would like to present a scholarship to Mr. Peyton Squire in the amount of $2,000.
My name is Steve Middleby. I'm here tonight representing the American Legion and the Sons of American Legion. In the past few years, we have worked to uphold the American Legion service to the Green County. Every year, we give out the scholarships, plus we mail out 180 thank you cards to our veterans. And at Christmas time, we buy gifts for around 20 kids in Green County, and we deliver fruit baskets to our veterans. J.W. Copey Award is our first Women's American Legion Day in the Copey Award, and I bet you have a little update on Mr. Copey. He was born in 1913 and died in 1997. He was a farmer. He went to the Army in August of 1941. During World War II, Mr. Copey served in China, Burma, and India. He was awarded 12 ribbons and medals and was honorably discharged in January of 1946 as Staff Sergeant. His son, Jimmy Copey, lives in Tennessee, but he still maintains a family farm here in Green County. Jimmy donates $1,000 to the American Legion and another $1,000 to the Sons of American Legion each year to honor their father. And the first scholarship was the J.W. Copey Citizenship Award of Eli Johnson. The next scholarship is a $1,000 scholarship goes to Mr. Alvin. The next scholarship goes to Wayne Gentry. And the last one and not least, this young man, I watched him grow up in the Sons of American Legion. I helped him kill his first deer. He's special to me, Mr. Eli Johnson. Thank you, Green County, for y'all's support. Without y'all's support, we couldn't raise the money to do this. Thank y'all.
We're here again. I'm here to give the 8th grade history of every student. I thought about doing that, but then you guys would just tell on me. So, I'm just going to give you some money instead. But you look good. Go Tops. On behalf of the Green County Fair and Horse Show, receiving the Walt Randall Milby Scholarship of $250, we have 3 recipients. The first is Dylan Gentry. The second recipient, Eli Johnson. Our last, Ivy Pittsman. Thank you.
see you at the fair, and I love all of you.
Good evening. I'm Melissa Bright, chairperson of the GTHS Alumni Scholarship Committee. This organization began in September of 2014 by members of the class of 1957 who wished to help a deserving graduating senior with cost for college. They envisioned funding the scholarship with monetary donations given by graduates of GTHS, and thankfully the new committee has also been able to continue this vision. We would like to thank all those who have so graciously given to our scholarship. This year, our fourth recipient of the GCHS Alumni Scholarship is Mackenzie Sky Moss.
Hannah Good, fitness. name's Carrie Davis, Market President from Limestone Bank, and we'd like to extend our congratulations to each one of you that graduated, and may the best in life yet to come. We are the administrators of the Heated Years of the WBHAL Awards. These are scholarships set aside each year, and the first group will be receiving the Heated Years Award. Each student will receive $5,850. So call your name, please come forward. Cheyenne Price. Mitchell Fayton Squire. The next group will receive the HAL Award. Each one of us will receive $1,000. The first one goes to Shelby Evelyn Howard. The next one is Megan Leanne Collins.
On behalf of the Wheel of Citizens, we have four scholarships to give tonight. Congratulating the class of 2018, parents, teachers, and all for your hard work over 13 years. Each year we try to help individuals as they continue their education, and it is very important for us to continue a lifestyle of being great for our community. First scholarship goes to Amber Bishop. Congratulations to all graduating seniors, and may God bless you.
may get this thing right one of these years. This is my third year, I believe, and this is the third year of the George Caldwell Jr. Memorial Scholarship Award. I have his brother with me tonight, Reverend Caldwell. Amen. Before I get ready to present the scholarships, I got it in my pocket somewhere. I didn't bring the onion tonight. I left it at home. But I want to give everybody something, as I always do, so that nobody feel that they are left out. Before I give to everybody, I want to say about the recipients of the scholarship. This is the first time I guess I've done something right. Last year we had one person put in for a scholarship of this. So this year, we end up getting 14 from Green Gap. So I think they were listening to something that I said last year. Amen. And that is truly a blessing. This year we gave 27 scholarships. But Green get the cake, you got the 14. And that is wonderful. Tonight I'm going to give everybody a three-piece chicken dinner. I brought you a three-piece chicken dinner. Before I give you my money, I tell my children, I'm going to preach to you first. Then I'll give you my money after I get through preaching to you. And I brought the three-piece chicken dinner because I want to just for a few minutes talk about sowing and reaping. And these are just some things for everybody, not just radicals, but all of us. All people have to sometimes to give something in order to get something. All people sometimes have to give the divine deposit that God has given you. You've got to pass it on to somebody else because you're not going to be here forever. And you want to keep things going. The scripture reminds us to be partakers of the Lord's goodness and return to Him. And don't come to Him with your hand. So basically what we're saying, when somebody gives to you, you give back to somebody else so you may help somebody along the way. I think the only way the Lord can be a blessing to you, you be a blessing to somebody else. And let me move to my clothes here quickly tonight because we got a lot. And remember this, that we all need someone we can depend on. Amen. You need to always have you a good somebody that you can depend on when you need. Batman had Robin. Robin stood by his side. Cato had the Green Hornet. The Long Ranger had Tonto. Saul had Pepper. Moses had Joshua. Jesus had the 12 disciples. And he sent them out by two. And let me tell you, when you get down and out, when you're out by two, you always have someone to pick you up when you are down and out. You may be hard-pressed in life, but you are not suffocated. Everything may be puzzled to you, but you are not utterly baffled. You may be struck down, but you are not out of the fight. You may, if you sow good seeds, good things, you'll reap good life. But remember something I said to somebody in this call. And that is just people don't have to be nice to you. Always learn to say thank you. Good ways carry you further than your money will. We want to present these 14 scholarships. We want to start with amen. Mitchell Squires, wherever you are, come this way. $1,000, you know, we ain't quite broke.
plan on graduating next year. Now, don't forget to get with the council and get the paperwork. You turn it in, and I guarantee you, if I see your name, I will make sure you get one of these making pies. Some didn't put the bills in, and I told them after we reviewed, I said, you didn't put it in, so we ain't giving you that. Rent that car away. You get a man on down, the council will give them to you. You'll send them about February, but I'll start preaching in November about it. They're in awesome condition. It's very important that this is able to we as students. I'm young. Crystal Radley. Don't spend it all in one place. Shauna Walker.
And as we have all said so many times, ride on Peyton.
In honor of Peyton, we would like to present two scholarships in the amount of $500. We can't think of two more deserving young men to receive this award. The recipients of this year's awards are Andrew Mosby and Gannon Irving.
Scholarship. thanks to you, God, and I have my nephew. Anyway, one of our dying wishes was to take some money,
put it in the bank,
and because I need to stay still. And as it grew, at the end of the year, it was to be given as a scholarship. Aunt Mary had one child. He died at about the age of six, which really kind of hard on her these days in modern medicine. The child would not have died, but he did. And again, that was one reason that she wanted to have a scholarship. She wanted kids or young adults to be able to go to school that may, you know, not be able to afford it themselves, or they were one of these that could not, how do I say this, could not get a lot of assistance because it's one thing or another. This year was a little bit different for us. We have two we're going to give away, which I know the hobbies in this year is going to pick my butt, but anyway, we do have two. One of them is very special, both of them are special, but one of them is not really special. And I'm going to let Mrs. Batman and her dad award this one. And then I'll do the second one. And may I say, y'all are very handsome bunch of beautiful ladies. And I wish you much love in the future. Just remember when you go out in the world, take God with you. He helped me coming in here, Mr. John. Running late as always, if you know me. But ran into a lady outside and I said, "You happen to know this?" And she's like, "Yeah, I sure do." And then I'm like, "You're not so lonely, because I left it home." And her, anyway, she'll tell whoever it is in a minute, because I bought them one surprise. But anyway, it was somebody that really knew her. So, without further ado, I'll let Morgan, that's mom, I'm sorry. Madeline, sound like a mom, going through the list of names and get the right one. But give the first one away.
Nunky.
First one goes to the Mason Show. And the second is to bring it all up.
This is a cat cash scholarship for the use of money as anyone. Which has some pretty nice books, tuition, gas.
So Lizzie Field, so enjoy,
thank you.
Hello, my name is Sarah Sluger, and I'm the Pearsall major in PTO. I'm presenting a scholarship at a value of $500, and this is for the recipient to use for his or her future endeavors with college. It is my honor to give the scholarship to Mr. Mitchell Payton Squires.
On behalf of the Green County Primary School PTO, I am Erica Sprouse along with Crystal Cecil. And we would like to present Ms. Megan Piles with a $500 cash scholarship. On a side note, I am also a member of the Green County Distinguished Young Woman Committee, and I have been informed that we have accidentally left out an award. If Shauna Walker would please stand.
Good evening. My name is Mindy Lasley, and I'm a member of the Board of Trustees of the Summersville Elementary School Scholarship Trust. Each year since the school closed, we have given out a $500 scholarship. We used to say to someone who completed their elementary school education in Summersville, but now, as the years passed, we have to say who started kindergarten there and was there until the school closed. We had several applications this year that were all outstanding, but I would have to say, in my more than a decade of doing this now, this is probably the most prepared and best prepared scholarship application I have ever seen. We are proud to give this year's award to Mackenzie Sky Moss.
Cody Greer was a graduate of the class of 2014. Cody lived a short life, but was never anything shy of the best life that he could have lived. I had the privilege of becoming not only a friend, but a brother to him throughout many years of his life. He was a one-of-a-kind individual that would do absolutely anything in his power to help someone in need. He had the biggest heart that I could ever notice in any boy that I had ever been around. His ambitious and strategic plan was cut short when Cody was diagnosed with leukemia in June 2015. He would later earn his ticket to be with God in July 2015. Although it was hard to bear the loss of Cody, I as well as others seemed to find peace in the legacy that he left behind. One of his biggest goals in life was to become a doctor. This career would allow Cody to do what he done best, helping others in need. So like Cody, we would like to continue his selflessness in honor of Cody's life, legacy, as well as his dreams, and award this $1,000 scholarship to Christina Perkins. The scholarship can be used to help cover some of the costs of entering nursing school or a program of her choice. Congratulations, Christine.
Good evening. I am Lisa Curry Pruitt, and I am here on behalf of Ford Bank. Congratulations to the class of 2018 for your many accomplishments and all your hard work. This evening, I am honored to recognize four individuals for the Ford Bank Cash Scholarship. As I call your name, please come forward to receive your award. This first one, Marla asked me if I would mind giving a hug, and I told her I would be honored to. As a matter of fact, I'd be honored to give a hug to all of them. Mr. Danny Durbin.
On behalf of the American Red Cross, I would
Gentry. Good evening. My name is Staff Sergeant Nelson. I'm a local Marine Corps recruiter. I want to thank the staff and faculty of Green County High School for allowing me to be here tonight to present these awards. Since 1775, the Marine Corps has been looking for a few highly qualified young men and women who, with a strong desire, challenge mentally, emotionally, and physically. As Marines, we gladly accept, adapt to, and overcome any challenge that we face. Each student here has faced many challenges through school, from demanding homework to exhausting sports practices to grueling final exams. I am here tonight to recognize five students who have distinguished themselves in the area of academic, athletic, and musical leadership. Each of these students has been hand-selected by their teachers and coaches because they have shown the greatest determination in the pursuit of their studies and have inspired others by excelling, adapting, and overcoming the challenges. On behalf of the Marine Corps, it is my pleasure to present this year's awards. The Semper Fidelis Music Award is for those students that have dedicated themselves and have the discipline to set themselves apart from the music department. Parker Bagley. The Distinguished Athlete Award is for those students that have displayed courage, poise, and self-confidence and leadership as a high school athlete. Jedrick Tronsell is the band judge. And the Scholastic Achievement Award is for academic achievement and leadership as a high school scholar. Matthew Gibbons and Shelby Hoffman.
Noah Curry, welding manufacturing,
fundamental marketing concepts, WorkBees, COSA, and CORES. Shelby Ford, pre-nursing, WorkBees. Gracie Frank, business multimedia, Microsoft Office specialist, Excel, Access, PowerPoint, and Word. Dylan Gentry, pre-nursing, WorkBees, COSA, and CORES. Matthew Gibbons, marketing, youth sports marketing, and certification of fundamental mental marketing concepts, Gold, WorkBees, COSA, and CORES. Austin Hatch, computerized manufacturing and machining, NIMS certification, WorkBees, and CORES. Kenzie Hampton, computerized manufacturing and machining, WorkBees. Dylan Pace, computerized manufacturing and machining, COSA. James P., computerized manufacturing and machining, NIMS certification, WorkBees, and CORES. Sean P., wood manufacturing, COSA. Abby Hedgehead, pre-nursing, state registered nursing assistant certification, WorkBees, COSA, and CORES. Jessica Higgins, pre-nursing, state registered nursing assistant certification, and COSA. Alexandria Howard, marketing, ASC certification and fundamental marketing concepts, COSA, and CORES. Shelby Howard, pre-nursing, state registered nursing assistant certification, Gold, WorkBees, COSA, and CORES. Elijah Johnson, welding manufacturing, AWS-2-F certification, WorkBees, COSA, and CORES. Hannah Judd, pre-nursing, WorkBees, COSA, and CORES. Riley Judd, business and pre-nursing, state registered nursing assistant certification. Taylor Judd, business, Microsoft Office specialist, Excel, PowerPoint and PowerPoint certification, Gold, WorkBees, and CORES. Christian Carnes, business and marketing program, both business and marketing program, WorkBees, COSA, and CORES. Cody Larimore, welding manufacturing, AWS-2-F certification, WorkBees, and CORES. Lyric Milby, pre-nursing, state registered nursing assistant certification, WorkBees, COSA, and CORES. Madison Montgomery, pre-nursing, state registered nursing assistant certification, Gold, WorkBees, COSA, and CORES. Wyatt Montgomery, welding manufacturing, AWS-2-F certification, and CORES. Katherine Peterson, pre-nursing, state registered nursing assistant certification, and CORES. Jada Pierce, pre-nursing, COSA. Keaton Pierce, welding manufacturing, AWS-2-F certification, and CORES. Cecily Holsley, pre-nursing, state registered nursing assistant certification. Tyrone Pointer, marketing, ASC certification, fundamental marketing concepts, WorkBees, and CORES. Cheyenne Price, business multimedia, Word office specialist, Excel, Access, PowerPoint, and Word. Megan Pines, pre-nursing, state registered nursing assistant certification, WorkBees, COSA, and CORES. Dylan Gray, wood manufacturing, COSA.
Rachel Rigdon, Business Multimedia, Microsoft Office Specialist, Florida. Clayton Riggs, Automotive Program, ASC Certification, and Automotive Maintenance and Light Repair and Electronic Systems and Ports. Devin Robertson, Welding Manufacturing, AWS 2-L Certification Ports. Mason Sharp, Welding Manufacturing, AWS 2-F Certification and Ports. Cameron Shirley, Automotive Program, ASC Certification, Automotive Maintenance and Light Repair, Steering and Suspension, Brakes and Electronic Systems, and Cords. Ezra Shirley, Computerized Manufacturing and Machining, NIMS Certification, COSA, and Cords. William Simpson, Pre-Nursing, Gold Workpiece, COSA, and Cords. James Stallard, Business Multimedia, Microsoft Office Specialist, PowerPoint, Workpiece, and Boards. Gavin Thornton, Automotive Program, ASC Certification, Automotive Maintenance and Light Repair, COSA, and Boards. Dextral Troxel, Business Marketing, AS Certification and Fundamental Marketing Concepts, Gold Workpiece, and Cords. Anita Van Voss, Pre-Nursing, State Registered Nursing Assistant Certification, Workpiece, COSA, and Cords. Shauna Walker, Business Multimedia, Microsoft Office Specialist, Word, Access, PowerPoint, Excel, Workpiece, and Cords. Sarah Wright, Pre-Nursing, Workpiece. Isaac Young, Marketing, ASC Certification, and Fundamental Marketing Concepts, Workpiece, and Cords. Students, well done. May your future be bright and blessed.
Goes to Peyton Squires. be presented by Tresinda Kimber, goes to Sarah Wright. The Biological Science Award will go to Taylor Cook. The Chemistry Award presented by Ms. Bright goes to Matthew Gibbons. Course Award presented by Ms. Markham goes to Savannah Mitchell. The English Award presented by Ms. Courtney Mooney goes to Matthew Gibbons. The Family Consumer Science Award presented by Ms. Emily Murray goes to Allie Hack. The History Award presented by Ms. Casey Lay goes to Lane Gentry. John Phillips Sixth Band Award presented by Mr. Nathan Wilby goes to Autumn Prayer. The Journalism Senior Yearbook Award presented by Ms. Casey Lay goes to James Shoemaker. The Mathematics Award presented by Ms. Amanda Olson goes to Mason Ackley. The Social Studies Award presented by Ms. Nancy Lay goes to Dylan Ginger. The Spanish Award presented by Ms. Lisa Fettel goes to Matthew Gibbons. The FCA Award presented by Ms. Mary Markham goes to Grace Frank. The ATC Hill Science Host Award presented by Ms. Karen Kempton goes to Christina Perkins. The DECA and Marketing Award presented by Ms. Sandy Smith goes to Matthew Gibbons. The Machine Tool Award presented by Mr. Barry Porter goes to Michael Heath. The Outstanding ATC HOSA Award Achievement Award goes to Brandon Conwell. The Athletic Award for Female Athlete Award goes to Hannah Judd. And the Male Athletic Award goes to Denver Crosby. The Citizenship Awards presented by Ms. Markham goes to Female Sky Moss. And the other recipient is Matthew Gibbons. Attendance Award presented by Mr. Clay Graham. Present every
13 years at Howell.
GPA. They have at least a 21 of composite
They have been involved in various activities during high school, and they will receive gold honor course for Friday night. Parker Bagby, Hannah Judd, Cody Larimore, Rachel Rigdon. Those honor students who are finishing magna cum laude with a 3.7 to 3.849 GPA, a 21 ACT composite or higher, and involvement in school activities will receive green and gold honor cords for Friday night. Brinley Caldwell, Rachel Fonfera, Dylan Gentry, Ivy Hedgebeck, Autumn Kreps, Savannah Mitchell, Megan Piles, Erica Smith, Dedrick Troxel, and Kaylee Wright. Those students graduating summa cum laude with a 3.85 to 4.0 GPA, a 21 ACT composite or higher, and involvement in multiple activities receiving green, gold, and white honor cords are Mason Atwood, Maria Grace Frank, Matthew Gibbons, Shelby Howell, Taylor Judd, Madison Matney, Madison Montgomery, Mackenzie Sky Moss, Cheyenne Price, Crystal Ratliff, Mitchell Payton Squires, and A.J. Vandenboss. We also have four students who, after 4 years of high school, have maintained a perfect 4.0 GPA, and they will receive a Senior Scholar Medallion. You heard from one of these young people last night as Taylor Judd gave your classmate address, and on Friday night you will hear from Matthew Gibbons as he gives our commencement address. But these four seniors who have maintained a 4.0 and achieved Senior Scholar status are Matthew Gibbons, Shelby Howell, Taylor Judd, and Mackenzie Sky Moss. I only went 5 minutes over, that was close. Okay. If you've lost count, these young ladies and gentlemen sitting around this gym floor tonight are taking home over $2 million. Worth of awards and scholarships from colleges and universities across this state. We are extremely proud of this group. Oh, Ms. Skaggs is giving me the total, I don't know if I can read it or not. $2,679,580 worth of scholarship money. We appreciate you all being in attendance tonight and for the support that you have shown these ladies and gentlemen, as they've been students at Green County High School. We would ask that you join us on Friday night, 7 p.m. Central Time, for commencement exercises. And class of 2018, before you take off, everybody who received an award over here to the bleachers so we can get pictures. Nobody leaves without a picture. Thank you all for your attendance. Be safe going home, and we'd love to see you on Friday night.